Once again, this is Dr. Hatem Eleishi from Dr. Hatem Eleishi Medical Center in Cairo, Egypt. This is the second video of the series Autoimmune Rheumatic Diseases Patient Series. If you have been diagnosed with an autoimmune rheumatic disease, you definitely ask this question: why me? Why this autoimmune disease happened specially to me? Let's start with how this autoimmune disease started in your body, and then we proceed to why this happened specially to you. How this autoimmune disease started in your body? It started like this. Now, you see in the figure here, this is your immune system. Those are the joints of your body, and your immune system is looking to the joints and telling them, who are you? Your immune system actually failed to recognize your joints as part of your body. If your joints are not seen as body, as part of my body, then the immune system will probably see them as some kind of microbe maybe coming from outside the body and trying to invade my body. So the natural thing, it has to attack them back and get rid of them. So the hallmark of autoimmune rheumatic diseases, or autoimmune diseases in general, is this misrecognition problem. In medical terms, we call it immune dysregulation. This misrecognition can also involve other body organs as well, depending on which rheumatic disease we are talking about, as we mentioned in the first video of this series. Like in this model, for example, we will assume that the immune system cannot recognize the lung tissue and the kidney tissue also, in addition to the joints. And so the immune system, in addition to attacking the joints, will also attack those organs. Any organ in the body, joint or other organ, that is attacked by the immune system in this model becomes inflamed. But why this misrecognition problem happened to you in particular? That brings us to the second question. Why this happened specially to you? You were born with a button for the misrecognition that would happen in your particular disease. That button was on the off mode the day you were born. Inheriting the button imparts susceptibility only to the disease, readiness for the disease. Inheriting the button does not mean you have to get the disease. Only if the button gets switched on someday can you get the disease. What could switch on this button? Well, psychological stress maybe can switch on the button. Some infection, an infection that you had several times in your life before, but this time it shows to switch on the button. Some hormonal changes, other environmental factors, any one of those can switch on the button. What happens when this button is switched on is the misrecognition starts. The immune system looks at your joints, oh, I don't know you. He used to know them before, but now when this button is switched on, who are you? I don't know you. And then the immune system accordingly starts to attack the joints. And when the joints are attacked, the joints get inflamed and painful. And this is how and why this autoimmune rheumatic disease happened specially to you. Could you have prevented this autoimmune disease? Can you prevent an autoimmune disease in someone who is susceptible to it? Your children, for example? Well, right now, we still cannot. But this is one of the very hot areas of current research in the field of the science called proteomics. And maybe in the near future, we can give you a better answer for that question. The next video in this series is titled How Doctors Diagnose a Patient with an Autoimmune Rheumatic Disease. It's the first video of the second section of the series, the diagnosis section.